Look, I've had to make a few other changes. I'm promoting you. Platoon sergeant.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
You bet.
Yeah, the trouble is, I already told my men I'd see them through this.
Is that your James Cagney impersonation? Because I've heard better.
Well, I'll keep practicing now.
But this isn't your first time through this. You don't need to prove anything.
No, sir.
You're not the best sergeant I've ever had. You're just the best one that's still walking. Locke's a good man.
Yes, sir, he is.
Men know him, he can step right in. You know, I have actually thought this through. Platoon sergeant puts you further away from the bullets.
I already gave him my word, sir. I told him to bring them all home to their mothers, which means I already lied to half of them, can't lie to the rest.
幸存的老兵曾回忆说，每个人都崇拜迈克尔，他是一个天生的领导者，一个以身作则的领导人，我们都非常喜欢他。他从未离过岗位，他是一位有经验的战士，但他从不谈论他自己。他对我们的关心是发自内心的，就像大哥哥一样照顾我们。那时的我们都是些不懂事的小毛头，他总会安慰我们说，我想尽可能地把你们送回家，送到你们母亲的身边。也许正是这样一位真正的英雄，让导演伊斯特伍德在描写他阵亡的情景时，加入了许多自己的感情色彩。
Sergeant! Sergeant! Mark!
Mike,
hey, where's Doc?
Foreman!
Oh shit!
How's his breathing? Harlan, move, buddy. Hey, Mike.
Yeah.
Mike, can you hear us?
Mike.
It's okay.
Come on, Mike.
Mike, can you hear us?
Okay.
I'm gonna get a stretcher. Let's take him down and move him up.
历史上对迈克尔阵亡的情景是这样描述的，1945年3月1日，迈克尔在沙地上给士兵们画分头撤离计划图，当他正准备抬头说话时，一颗炮弹飞了过来，炮弹准确地击中了他，迈克尔的胸腹部被撕裂，心脏被炸了出来，没有留任何临终遗言。很多人都相信这颗夺走他生命的炮弹来自美军自己的部队。